This video is straight to the point. If you use the Tommy Slav, I fucking hate you. You are a genuine disgrace to heavy players, and you should genuinely feel bad for using such a god-awful weapon. That's it. No ifs, ands, or buts. If you use the Tommy Slav, I genuinely fucking hate you.
How can you say that? It's obviously the best weapon for heavy. It's statistically the best. How could you say that?
Yeah, how could I say that? Yeah, shut the fuck up, you gay nerd. You know what else is statistically the best thing you can do right now? Get a job and work out. Not play Tommy Slav Heavy at 4 a.m. on a Tuesday. Oh, you're not gonna do that? Yeah, that's what I thought. I'm looking at you, Big Joey Slapnuts. But more on your retarded ass later. I like playing as Harvey the Weepin' Guy. I really do. And when I decide I don't want to use the best minigun, you know, the stock, I decide to change it up. I think most people really only see the heavy as being one of those classes that can only use one or two options, and the rest are absolute utter shit. When that's not really the case. In your TF2 Center Highlander King of the Hill match, maybe you can't branch out. But in pub play, I use every fucking minigun, except the Tommy Slav because I'm not fucking retarded. Natasha? It's a great side grade, really underrated, and I'm still pissed it got its 20% less damage nerf when you're only under 50% of your base HP. Regardless of that, it's still a great minigun. The ability to slow down all classes, especially scouts and devilmen, can really be lifesavers. If you know how to use the Natasha, it's a great side grade. The Hulong Heater? Also a good choice. Most people bitch that they have ammo's issue with it, but if you can train yourself to watch your ammo spending habits, it can work wonders. It does more damage to enemies on fire, encourages you to fight toe-to-toe, and as many retards playing pyro in the average pub, this will shell the fuck out of kills. You will be nothing but rolling in corpses of your enemies. It's kind of a straight upgrade because you have 3 fucking pyros, 4, 5, who knows, even more, just running around doing their stupid scorch shot flog spamming, and you can just clean up with a free plus 15% extra damage on all your enemies. And what about the Brass Beast? Aside from you being slower than your favorite Martian releasing a new song, you deal a fuck ton of damage. And that 20% damage resistance does help. You become a semi-mobile sentry. But Tommy Slav? Really? Do you really think this is a good minigun, let alone objectively the best one? How? Because it's a silent spin-up gun? Because it fires a tighter cone of bullets? Or because it spins up faster? Sure, you may be quiet like you really should be if using the Tommy Slav, but you're going to be shooting a retarded pseudo-beam. On top of that, you're going to be shooting slower. You are playing as THE Harvey the Weepin' Guy. Yes, and I know what I'm saying. Harvey the Weepin' Guy. You have a massive fucking minigun, and you're meant to shoot a fuck ton of lead at close range. You are not a sniper. Who gives a shit about a tighter spread of bullets? Why would you choose for a retarded looking Thompson mixed minigun piece of shit? Instead of like sending kids to the timeout quarter with a dunce cap on them, we should make you play as heavy with the Tommy Slav. Do you really need to wear a bike helmet? Do we need to call a short bus for you in order so we can chaperone your stupid ass everywhere so you can get to school on time just so you can eat all the Elmer's glue in the bottles? This goes double time to you if you own an Australian Tommy Slav. You do realize that money could be used in a much more efficient way, or hell, even just a million other different ways. I really would sell that piece of shit. Use it for gas money, donate to a charity, hell, do something productive with it, please. No, I don't care if you got it as a drop for an NVM tour, it's fucking stupid, and if you don't sell it immediately, you are also fucking stupid. Speaking of fucking stupid, let's talk about Big Joey Slapnuts. Mister, I changed my name from Big Joey Slapnuts to just Big Joey because he doesn't want a scary name that may hurt his monetization. Mister, I play sweaty ass try hard. I have 3 medics shoved up my ass on a Tuesday morning on Frontier. You think I don't recall to what you said to me when I said to some random fuck, not even to you, because I didn't want to acknowledge your stupid ass, I said the, call me JD because I'm about to rock a fella. And then you just leaned your fat fucking face into your mic and you did this retarded, obnoxious laugh at me like, like that. And you just did that over and over again for like a good 15 seconds. Or how I was laughing at someone else on the enemy team in that same pub because I was laughing at them because they said they were using Reddit only for r/Weezer when Reddit came up in some fucking conversation and you did the exact same thing. Like, you did that shit. That's fucking annoying, isn't it? With your three medic girlfriends with their butt plugs shut up your ass while the server was jacking off over how amazing you were just being there. Mr. I bitch about how people didn't have anonymity, they wouldn't say all these awful, icky, mean things to me. Mr. I quit a real job that benefits society so I can become a YouTuber. Mr. I farmed my shitty Australian Tomislav. That guy? Big Joey Slapnuts? This is the average Tomislav user. A dude that is the embodiment of the average TF2 player and what they follow in terms of entertainment. I'm sorry, Joey, but I think if you really want to become a successful YouTuber, you actually need to be funny and entertaining, and try appealing to a more mature audience, because little kids don't have money so they can't donate to you while you pub stamp over little shitty children in TF2 for the 8,751,395th time. That, or you know, try to sound a little better with your shitty piano, knockoff Elton John.